Hey, this is Dustin with the Streamlabs team, and today we're going to talk about improving your settings while streaming Fortnite on Streamlabs OBS in Windows 10 on a single PC. Do keep in mind that getting the most FPS in a game is optimal if you're just playing the game by itself. Anything like uncapped frames will improve game performance, but if you're streaming on the same PC you game on, this will likely have a negative impact on the quality of your stream. If you don't want to do anything that reduces gaming performance, you may need to consider a separate streaming PC. Another thing to keep in mind is that hardware is an important part of streaming and gaming on a single PC setup. While the settings we go with in this guide will help, most streamers that game and stream on the same PC without issues typically have an Intel Core i7 CPU or better, or an AMD Ryzen 7 CPU or better, as well as 16GB of RAM. Hardware provides the resources you have available for gaming and streaming on a single PC. The less resources you have due to less powerful hardware, the more likely either game or streaming performance will be negatively impacted. With that all covered, we'll get into the various settings we'll go through to improve your Fortnite streaming experience with Streamlabs OBS on Windows 10. Fortnite game settings, Windows 10 settings, Streamlabs OBS settings, updating graphics card drivers, and potential hardware upgrades. Let's talk about Fortnite game settings. Most everyone's hardware setup is different, so you may need to experiment with settings that provide your stream and game the best quality and performance. But in our examples, we'll set most of ours to low and cap our frame rate. For window mode, set your game to full screen, as games like Fortnite get the most benefit if you're in full screen versus a windowed mode. For display resolution, if you're not in full screen mode, 1920 by 1080 is ideal. But if your hardware setup can't handle this while streaming, you may need to set this to 1280 by 720. For frame rate limit, you'll want to set this to the display refresh rate of your monitor, as refresh rate is the amount of times your monitor refreshes every second. For our example, we have a 60Hz monitor, so we'll set our frame rate limit to 60 FPS. If you have a 120Hz or 144Hz monitor, you can set it to one of those values. But if performance is a problem, you may want to lower it to 60 FPS. For quality, we can set this to low, but we'll be further adjusting the settings further down the list. For 3D resolution, you can try to set yours to 1920 by 1080, but if your hardware can't handle it, then lower it further to 1280 by 720. For view distance, we'll set this to near. If your hardware can manage it, you can set it to far to be able to see more objects further away. For shadows, we'll set these to off. For anti-aliasing, if your hardware setup can handle this, you can set it to high, but we'll set ours to off. For textures, we'll set these to low. For effects, we'll set these to low. For post-processing, we'll set this to low. Since our frame rate limit is set to 60 FPS to match our monitor's refresh rate of 60Hz, we can have this off. If your frame rate limit greatly exceeds your monitor's refresh rate, you'll have to set VSync on, or your game will take away resources that could benefit your streaming software. For motion blur, we'll set this to off. And for show FPS, it simply displays your frame rate, so you can set this to on or off. Now, we can look into adjusting Windows 10 settings. Windows 10 has a game mode that, when enabled, can help some games perform better. Unfortunately, the game mode may cause less resources to be available to any streaming software, including Streamlabs OBS. To disable Windows 10 game mode, you'll need to go to the Windows Settings app in the Gaming section. Go to the Game Bar and turn Record Game Clips, Screenshots, and Broadcast Using Game Bar off. Do note that Windows 10 game mode is only available on Windows 10 releases starting from the Anniversary Update, build 14393. Another setting in Windows 10 that may negatively impact streaming and performance is Game DVR. This feature can be disabled in the Windows Settings app in the Gaming section, in the Game DVR tab. Turn off the Record in the background while I'm playing a game option. Do note that Windows 10 Game DVR is only available on Windows 10 releases starting from the Anniversary Update, build 14393. Now, we can look into making changes in Streamlabs OBS. Let's get into scene collections, scenes, and sources. With any streaming software, adding too many elements, such as too many scenes in a scene collection, or too many sources in a scene can impact performance. While your scenes and sources may work fine for most games, Fortnite may be taking up many resources that don't leave much for Streamlabs OBS, so you may need to simplify your scenes and sources when streaming this game. If you have a lot of scenes in a scene collection, try deleting some scenes to improve performance. This can be done by selecting a scene and clicking the minus sign by the scenes list, or you can right-click the scene and click remove. If you can also simplify your sources in the scene, you can do the same thing by selecting the source in the sources list and click minus, or by right-clicking the source and clicking remove. As far as sources go, browser sources can sometimes be more resource-intensive than other sources. If you find that you're experiencing problems with streaming performance with Fortnite, try removing browser sources to improve performance. Sources under the Widgets Gallery section are related to browser sources and may need to be removed from your sources list if you need to improve performance as well. We also have optimized encoder settings available for Fortnite. So when you click Go Live, after you've set Fortnite as your game, you can check the Use Optimized Encoder Settings checkbox to get better visual quality with Fortnite. Also, make sure your GPU's drivers are the newest available. So if you have an NVIDIA GPU, go to NVIDIA's site and grab the newest driver for your graphics card. If you have an AMD GPU, go to AMD's site and get the newest driver for your graphics card there. Again, it's important to have your hardware setup in mind. Your hardware setup is the amount of resources your system has available for both gaming and streaming if you're doing both on a single PC. This covers the various ways you can make changes to Fortnite game settings, Windows 10 settings, Streamlabs OBS settings, keeping your graphics card's drivers up to date, and PC hardware setup to make sure you can stream Fortnite and improve gaming and streaming performance. Be sure to download Streamlabs OBS by visiting streamlabs.com and hop into our Discord server at discord.gg/stream for live community support. Check out the links in the description below.